Okay, so we want to start to talk about and get into actual derivatives and calculus. So I want to talk about this problem that's out of your book. And it says, let's say, it says a company's total sales. And it says it's in millions of dollars. So let's keep that in mind. T months from today. Is given by this equation. So S of t is equal to 2 square root of t plus 6. Okay? And you can kind of get like a pretty easy graph of this, so maybe I'll just put this down. And let me see, I'm just going to make a t table over here. 2 square root of t plus 6. Let me get my calculator. Okay, so I don't need to look at values less than 0. So I'm going to start at 0 when I plug in. That gets me a square root of 6, so it gets somewhere around 4.9. But then if I keep going, let's see, like 3 will give me a. It's 2 times the square root of 9, so that's 6. The next perfect square after 9 is 16, right? So I need to plug in 10 to get that. So I'll plug in 10, and I get 8. And that might be enough. Let's look at this. Because the next one's 25, and I have to go all the way up to 19 to get 25 out of that, so, but it's 19 and then 10. The output is 10. Okay, so let me see how I want to graph this. That's fine if I add. Okay, so let's say we go by twos. Then I can get all the way up to 20 up here, and then really my outputs only go up to 10, so I might do 2, 4, 6, 8, one more, and get 10. Okay? And then when I graph this, I get 0 starting about here, right around 5. And then at 3, I'm at 6. At 10, I'm at 8. You'll forgive me if this is a little bit off because I don't have graph paper. I didn't load graph paper. So, but it looks like this, and it kind of has this shape because it's a square root. I know that it's kind of like this shaped and goes like this, but it definitely ends at 0. I'm not going to go backwards in time. Okay? Okay, now this is the total sales. So someone might be, for example, interested in how much sales changed each month. For the first 12 months. So from this point, starting point now, to that 12 months. So how much are sales changing? Or how much did sales grow each month? Okay, I mean, I can see this is an increasing function. So this is a question, and I want you to understand this. This is a question about change. How this function or how this quantity changes over time. And so we have a way to measure how things change. I don't know if you guys remember this, but one of the first and original measures of change is just slope, right? How much does the output increase if I go over one? Right? Change in y over change in x. Okay? So one of the things that you can do here is pretend, in some ways, or approximate this function with a straight line function. Pretend that's a straight line from those two dots to the other dots. And then the slope of that line gives you a good approximation to how things change. In fact, that's called the average rate of change. It's like averaging how much it changes, because it changes a different amount each month, right? But if I just kind of want to get a general sense of how it's changing, it's called the average rate of change. And what I would do is I would plug in the y values. It really is from slope. I use y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, right? And so here I want to do, let's say, from average rate of change from t equals 0 now to t equals 12 months from now. Okay? So I plugged in 0, and I know that that y value is 4 point. What did I say it was? 9? Is that right? Let me plug it in real quick. I know it's right up there. 4.9, and let me plug in 12, because we didn't plug that in. And at 12, I get a y value of 8.5. Okay? And so I come down here, let me go right here. I'm going to go right under this slope instead. And I'm going to put 8.5 minus 4.9, and then I subtract the x values, 12 minus 0. And I get about 0.3. Now, so in the context of this problem, let's go back. So this was total sales in millions of dollars. So 0.3 is 0.3, and then I have this is change in y over change in x. So it should be a change 0.3 and growth, right? It's positive 0.3, 0.3 million per, like, and on the bottom, oh, this is an x, per, and I have months, right? Per month. Okay? So, and usually we don't say, like, 0.3 million, but do you guys remember, like, if this is the millions place, like, let's say here, I have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and there's 1 million, right? So 3 million is, or 0.3 million is right here. It's really 300,000, right? Because you have this point that's where you imagine the point, and so there it is, $300,000 in growth of sales each month on average. Okay? So this is called the average rate of change. It's also called, so I want to go back up here. This approximating line that we drew right here is called the secant line. I'll show you how to find that secant line. So and then the slope is called this thing that we computed. This is the average rate of change. It's also called the slope of the secant line. Those two words. Okay, so like these, put these in your brain together. They're not different quantities, they're the same thing. Okay? Okay. Good. Okay, so I want to write this equation just real quick to make sure you guys know how to do this. So I have the slope of the secant line. It's this. I found that slope. And I also know a point on the line because I have those two points when I plugged in, like 0 and 4.9. So I have a point. 0, 4.9. You don't always use 0, so another point on the line is this point 12, and whatever, what was the output for 12? Let me see, 8.5 about. Or did I put 8.49? Let me see what I put. 8.5. Let's use that. Right? So these two x values are dependent on the problem. Okay, I don't always use zero. Sometimes that's hard to tell from examples. But I have a point, and then the slope I have is 0.3. Okay, so I can just put this in this. Do you remember the point slope form of the line? Something like this. So I get y minus, let me use this 8.5 and 12, 0.3 and x minus 12. And then you can solve for y. So this is 0.3x minus 12 times 3 tenths is 3.6, and then plus 8.5 from the left side. So I get a final line of 0.3x plus 4.9. And that's the equation of this green line that we drew up here that kind of closely approximates my original function, right? It's pretty close. It's not the exact same. It's off a little bit, like right in here. But, you know, it's pretty close. So the idea is kind of an approximation idea. This is the idea of an average. You lose some detail, but you get kind of a broad picture sort of thing.